First and foremost, how many people are familiar with CMMC? All right, maybe I should ask the question, is there anybody who needs me to give the history why we have CMMC, why we are where we are in the picture? Does anybody want to hear that? You've heard it enough, right? Okay. So here's, how many of you are old enough to remember, what was that TV show? Hee Haw. You remember Hee Haw? And remember the old lady sitting around talking, and they say, we don't gossip, so you better listen good the first time? This is where we're going to be, guys. Okay. Now, what we have said publicly before is we have to quit speaking about the rule when we're in the formal rulemaking process. So I'm here, so what does that mean, right? Okay. So where we think we are in the picture, we're still in the deliberative process for the rule. We do not have a formal judgment from OMB whether it'll be an interim or a proposed rule. That won't happen until they get the rule in full text to be able to look at. What I can tell you, I can't talk about what's in the rule, but they didn't tell me that I couldn't talk about what's not in the rule. So here's what I'm going to tell you. We are not going to have any gotchas in the rule. There are not going to be any changes to the requirements. When DoD did the review and the rewicker of the program to come out with CMMC 2.0, we agreed that the proper thing to do was to tie it to the NIST 800-171, right? We didn't want companies to have to come up with anything different, learn anything different, because y'all have all been doing NIST 800-171 since 2017, right? Every single one of you have it in your spaces. You're fully compliant. All right, how many of you are small businesses? Okay, how many of you are struggling to get your 800-171 together? Okay, so here's what I'm going to tell you. I got promoted but no money. That's the way they do it, right? So I'm now the chief of the DIB cybersecurity for CIO. Woo! Right? And as you all know, I'm a duck out of water because I'm an acquisition person that's now in IT. Yeah! Right? So I'm taking the classes. I'm getting my CISM certification. But one of the good things is I'm responsible for our interaction with you. So here's what I'm going to tell you. And I know there are people that have identified problems with Project Spectrum. And I want to let you know that I've been in touch with Melinda Woods. She's the program manager there. And they're working on everybody's comments to make sure that we have a good program. But they are still a great resource for companies to work with to help you find out what you need to do, and it's free. DC3. Has a program to help you walk through the NIST 800-171 and talk you through it. That's free. NSA has the Cyber Collaboration Center that can work with you. There are a ton of free capabilities out there. The sad part about it is we were going to put out a slick sheet for everybody to know where they could go for different things. But it starts to get convoluted because right now DC3 has authority to work with cleared defense contractors. We're doing, guess what, a rule change, right? These fun rules. That's why I'm getting ready to retire, I think. We're doing a rule change to expand that program to all of the DIB, right? So you guys would have the opportunity to work with DC3. One of the things that we need to hammer home with everybody, though, is we need that incident reporting. All right, I know most of the time it's voluntary, but it's very important. And they can help us figure out why we got hit, how we got hit, what the damage is, and help us figure a way out. It's not going to be a gotcha for companies. We're not going to go in and thwack you because you got a hit. But, you know, I need that information across the board so I can know, okay, this control didn't protect me, right? And NIST is in the middle of a revision right now. The other cool thing that I'll tell you is tomorrow I get to brief the Federal CISO Council. How many are you, of you are aware that there's a FAR rule coming out, the FAR CUI rule? Okay, what does that do? That makes 800-171 for protection of CUI across all of the federal government. It's also going to implement the NIST 800-172, which are the requirements that we're going to have for that level 3 CMMC that's going to be the higher criticality. That's what's going to implement that, right? So keep your eyes peeled for that. That should be coming out for public comment soon. I think they're stuck in the deliberative process as well. It's never fast. It's never easy. But those are things. So when I go to talk to that CISO council tomorrow, the thing that we want to bring up and get everybody on the same page is let's evaluate those requirements the same way across the entire federal government, right? We don't want DoD saying, oh, FIPS encryption, that's like the most important thing, and somebody else going, yeah, that's not that big of a deal, right? Because then you're going to have answer to too many different masters, and that's not going to be efficient for the DIB. So pray that I get the message across well to them tomorrow and we all get on the same page. I am not going to suggest that everybody adopt CMMC because I think they're all armed for bear thinking that's why I'm coming, and the message will get lost. There are some agencies out there that I hope they have better success than we did that intend to allow it to be still a self-assessment by companies. But as we found out, that didn't work too good.